What's up, YouTube? Emily coming at you. Woo! Yeah! Fitness! Oh, yeah! Healthy life!
I want you to shut up.
For sure. Proceed!
I can't.
Thanks, my name's Matt. I'm here all week.
What's up, guys? Now that Matt's done with his little tirade, I can talk to you guys. Today, I am filming a full day of eating for you guys, but it is also episode one of getting shredded for summer. Although it's more like getting shredded for EDC, because that's actually what I wanna be shredded for right now, which is in May. I'm gonna be talking about food, what I eat in a day, but I've been getting a lot of questions about calories and macros, you know, if I count my calories or what are my macros. I used to put everything into my fitness pal and do the whole thing, but now I kind of just have a rough estimate of the macros that I eat. Meal prep helps me sort of get a gauge of the macros that I'm eating, because I have these set meals that I have it planned out beforehand, but I don't go in and like weigh every single item. So I'm just gonna kind of give you a guesstimate of the macros that I'm eating. So this morning I had my apple cider vinegar drink, which is just warm water, juice from half a lemon, and then 3 or 4 capfuls of apple cider vinegar. And then I had some coffee with some almond milk. And then I went for a run. I got back and made breakfast, which was 1 whole egg, some egg whites, bell pepper and onion, and then 2 pieces of toast. The macros on that are about 25 to 30 grams of carbs, 15 to 20 grams of protein, fat from the eggs and the coconut oil that I used to cook the veggies in, which was about 7-ish grams of fat, 7 to 10 maybe. So that was breakfast, and now I am going to go to the gym with Matthew. I'll see you guys back here for lunch. I got back from the gym. I didn't do anything crazy, just a little bit of upper body stuff. I worked on some pull-ups, some dips, and then a little bit of back and tricep work. What I'm gonna have for my post-workout is a delicious smoothie, because I've also stopped eating oats. I know, you're shocked right now, but everybody, relax. The way I made my oats, I always made it with whey protein, and that's what made it like so sweet and delicious and amazing. I have been doing a lot of research and trying to figure out why my skin is breaking out so bad, and I've heard that whey can make people break out more. I stopped using whey, and now I'm using a pea protein, and it's really good, and it goes really well in my smoothies. I did try it in oats. It's not as good, it's okay, but I would much rather have it in a smoothie. It's only been a week, but my skin is so much better. So I think if I continue with this and I continue to have clear skin, then I think I know that whey was probably the culprit. Anyways, I'm gonna make my smoothie now. Smoothie, smoothie, we're making smoothies. My smoothie, half a banana, about a cup of frozen berries, some Tropica pea protein, as well as some collagen, which is another thing I'm trying out for my skin, some almond milk and some water. Normally I do all almond milk, but I ran out. What are you gonna do? Macros for this: carbs from the fruit, about 30 grams 30 35 maybe, a little bit of fat from almond milk, not a whole lot, like 2.5 grams for a whole cup, and I didn't even use a whole cup. And then protein, about 25 from the collagen as well as from the pea protein. Pretty solid little post-workout drink. We're gonna watch Fast 6 because we watched Fast 5 yesterday. Also, because I am going to be real with you guys, I am going to document my singular bite of Matt's Chipotle bowl, because oh my god, look at that. That was amazing. I literally just downed that smoothie in like 30 seconds, and I know I'm so hungry. I'm gonna heat up my meal prepped meal. So let's get that out. So this is it. Looks a little weird. All it is some roasted sweet potatoes, which is basically the base for a lot of my meal prepped meals. And then I made a chicken tomato curry. And because I meal prepped that, I basically already know the macros. It's about 30 grams of protein, 10 grams of fat, another 30 grams of carbs. We got carbs from the veggies, which I have cauliflower and green beans in there, and then carbs mostly from the sweet potato, and then protein from the chicken, and fat from the oil that I was cooked with, as well as the coconut milk that I put in there. And there's also tomato puree in there to make it all saucy. It's honestly delicious. Anyway, so I'm gonna heat this up and eat it because I'm still very hungry even after I just downed that smoothie. Yeah, time to watch Fast 6. So for my salad, I've got a base of spring mix here, and then I am going to put on some cucumber, red onion, some grape tomatoes, and some bell pepper. And then I just have some rotisserie chicken, and then I just have my salad dressing here, which I made, which is just tahini, lemon juice, and salt. And then I'm also gonna put on some of this tzatziki and baba ganoush, and that'll be my salad. So this is my dinner. Basically, I always have a salad at least once a day usually. So the macros for this. Carbs are mostly from all the veggies and the tzatziki and the baba ganoush. I would probably say somewhere around 15-ish. It's a huge guesstimate, but we're going with it. And then protein from the chicken, probably around 20 to 25. And then fat from the salad dressing and the tzatziki and the baba ganoush as well. Probably somewhere around 15 plus. Grams of fat. Oh, and also with dinner, I'm going to have a LaCroix because LaCroix is great. LaCroix is life. And then after dinner, I'll probably have something to satisfy my sweet tooth. Usually I have dark chocolate, Usually I have dark chocolate, but I'm out right now, so we'll see. One thing I also wanted to note about salads, I talked about it in one of my more recent Instagram posts, but it's a great way to eat a lot of volume with a lot less calories when you're dieting. Volume, you know? After I ate my salad, I had a few pieces of frozen mango as like my little dessert. Probably another like 10-ish to 15 grams of carbs. Anyways, I'm like exhausted because I stayed up with Matt to watch Fast and Furious 7. It was just a day filled with Fast and Furious for the most part. And that was a productive day. It was a good day. But anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video of episode 1 of Getting Shreddy for EDC / Summer. Give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and stay tuned for episode 2 of Getting Shredded for Summer.